Hey guys, what's up? It's Joe Raiti from Raiti's Rides, and this weekend I am at the Rolex 24 at Daytona. If you look behind me, I have something very, very special for you. This is the new 2018 Team Joest Mazda prototype car. Now, if you don't know much about endurance racing, let me break it down for you. This weekend, there's actually going to be three classes of cars. You're going to have the DPI, which is your prototype class. That's where this runs. You're going to have GTLM, which are those factory-backed GT cars like the Corvette, the Ferrari, the new M8, and the Ford GT. And then you have what's called GTD. GTD is a tad closer to what you could get on the street. In that class, you're going to have Lamborghinis, Porsches, the new Lexus RCF, Acura NSX. So lots of competition. Let me tell you a little bit about this car. So Mazda originally ran this team and really wasn't having the best of luck. I have to say, personally, this is probably the most drop-dead sexy of the new prototypes I've ever seen, especially finished in Mazda's soul red. This is a special color that is specific to Mazda, and I really think it shows the lines perfectly on this car. This weekend, you're going to see this car compete against the factory Acura teams with Team Penske. You're going to see a bunch of private teams out there. It's going to be interesting to see who is going to win the Rolex 24. But let me go ahead and show you the front of this car and some of the aerodynamics. Let's go check it out. All right, here we are at the front end of the business. You can see the aerodynamics. You can see a lot of the styling things that you guys are finding on your own street cars. You're finding here at the track first. This is a huge, probably one of the biggest carbon fiber front splitters I've ever seen. I really like they took the Mazda logo. I really like how, like I said, they took that soul red. The aerodynamics is what this car is all about. Here at Daytona, this car is easily going over 200 miles an hour. I like the way this display car is positioned because remember, at Daytona, you got that 30 degrees of banking. And even though this isn't 30 degrees, you can give it a little bit of perspective of what this car is going to be like. I really like what Team Joest has done with the air intake on the roof. Obviously, that's going to force feed that engine back there and give that turbocharged engine all the power that it could run. But here at Daytona, a little different than a lot of other tracks, it's all about getting down that back straightaway and getting that high speed because, you know, the infield road course, it's not really that technical. So you don't have to run a lot of downforce like you would say at Laguna Seca or Watkins Glen or something like that. But let's go ahead and check out the side of the car so you can see a little bit more about the styling and how it helps with the airflow and everything. Let's check it out. All right, so you can see, guys, here at the side of the car, there's a lot of work that goes into wind tunnel testing and aerodynamic testing. A lot of different pieces that if you weren't here, it's hard to see at home watching this on your computer screen or your iPhone or whatnot. As you can see, where I'm placing my hand, there's lots of different foils, lots of different aerodynamics. This whole body's made out of carbon fiber. Right here, they have a nice raw piece of it to let you know what they're working with. As you work your way down the side, you can see how everything is shaped for speed on this car. These drivers, you're gonna have teams of 3 to 4 drivers in these cars. They're gonna be probably doing at least an hour, if not more, in the car for each driver stint, and they're gonna be having to change drivers throughout the whole night. So this race isn't about ultimate top speed, it's about who has the endurance to make it to the end. Let's check out the back of this Mazda prototype car. All right, we're at the back end of the business of this Mazda prototype race car. You can see the big, huge wings that they're running, and like I said, it's a balance. It's about having the downforce, but also cutting through that air as efficient as possible. Underneath the rear of this car is a lot of diffusers, a lot of tunnels to help direct that air. Remember, it's not about pushing, not only pushing the car down through the use of the rear wings, but also by pulling the car like a vacuum to the track. It's things like this that, guess what, are gonna wind up in your street car if they have not already. So I wanna thank you guys for watching. I have more action from the Rolex 24 coming up. And if you have something that you wanna see featured on Raiti's Rides, leave a comment in the comment section, visit my website or my Instagram, and just like always, guys, I'll see you on the next ride.